We want to write a function rule that performs the following operations in the given order, and we're asked to use f of x for our function. So for part A, our function multiplies by 3 and then adds 5. So if we're using f of x as our function, notice that x would be the input. So to multiply by 3, we'd multiply x by 3, which would be 3 times x, or 3x. And then we'd add 5 to this, so we have 3x plus 5. This would be our function rule. Notice, following the order of operations, if the input is x, we'd first multiply by 3 and then add 5. Looking at part B, the function now first adds 5 and then multiplies by 3. So we'll have to be a little more careful on part B. Our function f of x is going to be equal to, we'll first add 5 to the input of x, that would be x plus 5. But now we want to multiply this entire quantity, x plus 5, by 3. So we'll have to put x plus 5 in parentheses, and then to multiply, we can put the 3 up here in front. This would be 3 times the quantity x plus 5. So following the order of operations, we would add 5 to x first, and then multiply by 3. For part C, our function divides by 4, and then subtracts 7. So our function f of x would be equal to the input of x divided by 4, so x divided by 4, and then we subtract 7, so minus 7. And then for part D, the function first subtracts 7, and then divides by 4. So our function f of x would be equal to, again, we're first going to subtract 7 from the input of x, that would be x minus 7. But now we want to divide this entire quantity by 4. There's a couple ways of expressing this. We could write this in fraction form, where the numerator would be x minus 7, and our denominator would be 4. This would be the quantity x minus 7 divided by 4. Or if we wanted to, we could also write f of x equals, in parentheses, x minus 7, and then divided by 4. These are both equivalent, but this first form would be the most common. I hope you found these 4 examples helpful.